This video about making tweezers for a resistor soldering unit is part of our series on making a DIY resistant soldering iron. Links to that series are below and at the end of this video. The book of resistant soldering covers all those topics and a lot more. If you have any interest in resistant soldering at all, the book is well worth downloading. I made two sets of tweezers or pincers. Very easy again to make. One set has very fine pointed tips. The other set, well, let me zoom in here first. Pointed tips, they work well on removing components from motherboards and getting in very tight places. And these tips are flattened so that they hold things. I use on shafts and holding materials in place. The tips themselves are mild steel. I cut them and shape them from a single-use grill, picnic grill, the stand. Very nice wire on the bottom. Cut it out, sharpened it, and put it in place. Now, as far as making the connection goes, very simple. Get this so you can see it in the light. I just used a terminal connector and put the tip and wire onto the end of the tongs. They're just hot glued in place on the end of the tongs. What I did was took terminal connector like this, sliced two sides off, and put them on the end of the tongs. Very simple. Very inexpensive. The wire I run down through the middle and out the end. Let me zoom out, the other out. The tongs, you can use spaghetti tongs, kitchen tongs, any kind of tongs you wish. And you can just very simply hot glue those pieces on the end. I had some wood from a fruit crate. I cut it, added a block at the end. I have some very nice tongs, very easy to use. And then I ran the wires down through the center. Be sure to use 15 gauge wire. That way, because it gets hot, you don't want resistance. You want everything, you want good current flow. You don't want thin wire. It adds resistance to the circuit. Plus, by putting the wires in the center, I don't have any problems with any heat. I don't have to add any extra cable or tape. Now, this one's short. I made it short for a reason, because I want to clamp things. And you can see the clamp tips here. Very effective. I use this one a lot. It's very nice when I'm working on very small shafts and very small pieces. I want to just make a quick bind. And even I can insert wires into banana plugs. Just put on a plug and step, and your joint is made. No waiting to heat up any soldering iron or anything. So that's how they work. So once again, I recommend strongly you download book. Nothing like having a book on your desk that you can refer to. I hope you have learned something from this video. If you have comments, need help, let me know. Have a good day. Have a good life. Thank you for watching.